yum, yum, the heat of summer is just around the corner. For most of us, that means hitting the beach and getting out into the sun. But how do we make sure that we're taking care of our skin and keeping our beauty routine up to speed in the warmer months? Well, thankfully, our beauty expert is on hand with all the hot tips for transitioning your beauty routine. Domenica Calarco is here with her gorgeous mum, Anna Maria, who's doing a bit of modelling for us today. Ladies, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Now, Domenica, how much does your beauty routine really have to change between winter and summer?
Well, it should be changing. Obviously, we're still cleansing and moisturising and that kind of thing, but I think amping it up with a really great exfoliator for summer, you know, get rid of all that dead skin cells that are
dry,
left, you know,
because
our skin's
winter.
So dry after winter. Mm. So that's what I've done for Mum this morning. Really great exfoliation. It's going to get that blood pumping and getting the collagen working. Mum and I both actually love getting Omnilux facials, which are like a light therapy, which stimulate collagen deeper in the epidermis. So, I mean, that's a little bit more of a, like...
a luxury, you know,
it's a luxury
for a lot
thing.
Of people,
yeah,
isn't
exactly,
it?
Exactly, yeah.
But an affordable way to sort of change things up is by using different sorts of makeup and different colours, isn't
it? Exactly, exactly. So starting with skin, I always say, mix a little bit of a liquid illuminator in your foundation or even in your moisturiser. So this one here by Mecca Max is amazing because not only is it only like $14, but it doesn't have like glitter or anything too shimmery in there. So really...
No glitter.
Well, you don't want to be putting too much glitter or something that's too illuminating on the face, because sometimes it can really over-highlight those, you know, fine lines and things around the eyes and around the lips. Mm-hmm. So you want to steer clear of that for older skin.
And so then you would mix that with your foundation, that particular...
Definitely. You can mix that in with your foundation or your primer.
Is that what you've done with your mum
today? That's what I've done for her today, yeah. So...
Okay. And I guess
cream
it's about...
blush.
Oh, it's
I love.
It's about keeping everything light, right?
Yes, so keeping things really light. I love using corals for summer. It's just, you know, really brings out that fresh look. And these Clinique Chubby Sticks are great because literally you just draw them on like this and then blend them out with your fingers. By using your fingers, you're really using the warmth that you've got there. You've got tools, you know, your hands. So just use them.
What do you
them.
Think about your daughter doing your makeup?
Oh, I love it. I never get enough.
Oh, I definitely love it.
Sometimes. Yeah.
But that won't sweat off. You know, sometimes when you get quite hot,
it moves.
Yeah.
No, these like really set well in the skin.
Okay.
So people always think, oh, I've got to use powders in summer. But honestly, creams are the way to go because they set on the face and they actually become waterproof. Mm. So if anything, they're
Better than powder.
Than powder, yeah.
It's really interesting because as you go out into the sun a bit more during summer, your skin starts to go a bit darker as well, your complexion, and if you don't change the colour of your foundation, you can look a bit mismatched with the rest of your body. So what do you sort of say
suggest.
Your best advice is
Yeah, so
there.
If you want to stay on a budget and you want to keep your same foundation that you have from, you know, winter and spring, I would definitely recommend going for a really lovely bronzer. Max Factor have actually just come out with these beautiful powders that are actually kind of like a cream.
Oh, it's a cream?
Yeah, but it's actually still a powder. It's a really amazing formula. Once again, doesn't have too much glitter in there. It's just a slight shimmer. So what I like to do and what tip I always tell Mum and her friends is that just get a bit on your brush.
Yep.
And then to mimic where the sun would naturally hit the face is on the forehead, under the cheekbone, and under the jawline. So
your
that's where the sun
is
naturally hits.
I'm
not on the nose.
Yeah, Mum's only 29, so. As she'd love
I've
me
been
to say.
That like that
and of
for
course,
a while.
Yeah, on the nose as well. So where the sun would naturally hit and where shadow would be created on your face.
Ooh.
Yeah.
And now I'm a huge eyelash fan.
Yes.
Love mascara, eyelash extensions.
I do as well.
What can we do summertime to really bring our eyes out?
Yes, so I think lashes are like number one. I can't live without my eyelash extensions, but they are a little bit of, once again, a luxury.
Yep.
And yeah, so for every day, curling the eyelashes. I think...
Well, I get scared using these.
I know, Mum actually gets scared on her. But honestly, I'll give you a few tips.
It's like a torture device.
Yeah, what I do is just look down.
Oh.
Don't hurt your mum.
I don't know if you can see that. And what I do is I just pulsate.
pulsate.
Yeah, like that.
I've never heard of a pulsating eyelash curler. That's
yeah,
great.
And so what it does is it will work to, like, go towards the ends of your lashes and really curl them around.
Is it true you could also warm up a teaspoon and use the back of the spoon to kind of bend it up as well?
Yeah, I mean, you can definitely do that. Heat helps because it's going to help the curl stay. But, I mean, good old-fashioned eyelash curler, can't go wrong.
How do you not get your skin, though? Because often you'll get in that little corner bit that pinches.
I mean, just make sure you have a mirror really close to you and just look down into a mirror. That's my number one tip. Even when you're applying mascara,
look down. Okay.
Yeah, so look down into a mirror and apply it that way. That way you're not, like, getting it... It doesn't transfer onto your brow bone and stuff like that. Yeah.
And, Domenica, we've been wearing berry lips and dark reds all winter. Now that it's summer, what should we be glossing on?
Oh, definitely go for more pinky, peachy undertones, 100%. I think they flutter every skin tone and it really goes with the eye look that I've done for Mum today. Used, once again, a new Max Factor.
That's so pretty, isn't
it?
All those colours.
This is so gorgeous. And honestly, they're so easy to blend out, especially for people that are just, you know, starting out with makeup or want to change up their look. These formulas are easy to blend out. You can even apply them with your fingers, which Mum loves.
Oh, really?
Because, you know, she doesn't have a lot of brushes and stuff like that. People don't want to spend money on blushes. So a nice pink with a little bit of frost.
Frosty
lips are coming back,
what?
Guys.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'm getting flashbacks. My teenage years.
But they're not the frost that everyone thinks. Yeah. So I just like to dab it on so it's not too intense because we don't want... too much of an intense frostiness.
And that is so pretty.
Yeah,
so would that sort of frosty lipstick be better than perhaps than using a gloss or something for older skin?
Definitely, but I think it's really important to still use balms. I really love this one by Frank Body. It's a beautiful lip balm. It smells like coffee. It keeps your lips hydrated all day. Get some of that on. It's
lovely. That is nice.
It's really nice. So yeah, put that on the lips and you're good to go.
Well, you can find more of Domenica's tips and tricks on her YouTube channel. Head to youtube.com/Domenica Calarco. Thank you so much for joining us, Anne-Marie. You look lovely.
Thank you.